The financial markets, Julia, are taking this, by the looks of things, very seriously. Why are they doing that? What is it in this reporting that is so concerning?
Good morning. The early reaction was indeed very bad. The ETF in London fell almost 10% fell almost 10%, which was the first reaction we saw. The main point here is Brazil markets have been rallying on hopes of a pension reform and as a broader reform agenda. And that was all in the back of President Temer's political abilities and connections. And that is now being seen as on hold at best.
On hold at best. I guess, is this now going to become what we are talking about in Brazil? Because, as you say, the markets really have been on a tear of late. Enthusiasm about that pension reform seen as being absolutely critical, unpopular but critical. Given what is now being reported, as you say, on hold is as good as it's going to get. Does it die? Does the reform momentum die with this story?
What Eurasia said was that it's not necessarily dead, but that Temer has lost the condition to negotiate it at this point, and that we need to reach a new political equilibrium, they call it. So for now, the entire country is just going to focus on this. There's another police operation this morning tied to the revelations that we got last night from the newspaper.
Right.
So it's too up in the air at this point.
Julia, let's look at the chart off the Bloomberg of real GDP in Brazil. Folks, it's not a pretty picture. The success of 15 years ago, think of it as a Lula success. Then down we go from the beginning of the financial crisis, Brazil with some volatility, and then just massive underperformance. Julia, give all of our viewers an update on rule of law in Brazil. How is the general state of law?
Police operations have, especially on the federal police and car wash, have increased tremendously. And this is what everyone sees as sort of a silver lining in Brazil. It shows that the institutions are working and that these investigations are being done. And once we are out of them, we will be left with a better country. I think the point is now, when will we be out of them? When will these be done?